La 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 la.
Hi everyone, Justin Shaved Tano here, the internet's busiest music nerd, and it is time for a review of the new Gil Scott-Heron and Micaiah McRaven record, We're New Again. This is a newly reimagined album from legendary singer, songwriter, and poet Gil Scott-Heron, as well as Chicago jazz musician Micaiah McRaven, which essentially rebuilds and refurbishes music and words from the recording sessions of Gil Scott-Heron's final record, I'm New Here, in 2010, which has grown on me quite a bit since the year it came out. When this album dropped, I don't even think I reviewed it as in 2010. I wasn't covering nearly as many genres or artists as I am today. So given this album was such a strong final statement from Gil, and this isn't even the only time this album has undergone a revision like this, there was that Jamie XX remix record from a while back too, I was pretty excited to hear what McRaven would bring to the table on this project, not just because he's a great jazz musician, but because he's also known as someone who brings impressive musicians together, and occasionally edits his recordings with a hip-hop flair. So it was already apparent going into this thing, we're going to hear maybe more hip-hop beats, more jazz influences, but maybe also McRaven would make this record sound a bit more uniform too, because the original album is a bit unpredictable at times, aesthetically, putting Gil over instrumental palettes you wouldn't necessarily expect to hear him on. Throbbing electronics, some dark and industrially tinged beats too, but ultimately I went into this record hoping to hear Gil's work displayed in a refreshing light, and it does feel that way, but only in isolated spots. The revision of Gil's cover of Bill Callahan's I'm New Here is fantastic, with its gentle harp flourishes and very easygoing hip-hop beat. The quiet vocal harmonies hiding in the background of the track are a very nice touch too. I dare to say this is a moment on the record where I actually prefer this version to the original. The instrumental palette on this one is just so gorgeous and organic and lightly groovy. It just feels like a collective performance. It's wonderful. And most importantly, Gil's vocals work so well into this instrumental, it doesn't feel like they're being repurposed from somewhere else, which I think is really the best thing you can hope for from an album like this. The revision of the Brooke Benton cover here is pretty ingenious as well, as it totally switches up the instrumental palette and presents the song anew as if it's like this 70s style soul ballad, which aesthetically is kind of reminiscent of a lot of Gil's older stuff, save for his very aged voice. But it's so impressive that it's the same vocals, same sound, but thanks to this backdrop change, the mood is entirely different. It just sounds like a beautiful, soaring ballad now. Meanwhile, Gil's take on the Robert Johnson original Me and the Devil is now soundtracked by a cacophonous piece of jazz rap, which does sync up nicely with Gil's very raspy and bluesy vocal riffs, but it did take me a few listens to really feel this one because the image of the original is just so lodged deep into my head because I do like it so much. But I still can't help but feel like the horns are off on this one, the way that they're blurting and harmonizing with everything else, it just feels, just awkward. Regardless, I still think this track serves as another good example of taking a pre-existing song, getting it to sound a totally different way while still tastefully tributing Gil's artistry. While not nearly as dreary, the instrumental switch up on People of Light is pretty nice as well. Originally, this track was Your Soul and Mine off of I'm New Here, and the lyrics on that cut, many of them and the messaging were lifted from an earlier Gil Scott piece, The Vulture, so this one has undergone quite a few evolutions at this point. And the framing this time around is totally unlike Your Soul and Mine, as well as The Vulture, as now Gil sounds like an old beat poet performing in a smoky jazz club over some very groovy drums and upright bass. The rest of the album, though, and there is quite a bit of it left, is mostly hit or miss for me and fails to build up any real momentum. One of the few criticisms I think you could lob at the original I'm New Here is that the record is a little brief, it is kind of fragmented, and McRaven decided to enhance that quality about the album by adding one interlude and vocal snippet after interlude and vocal snippet, really padding the tracklist out needlessly. This occasionally leads to McRaven breaking down some of this album's best tracks into repetitive jazzy motifs that don't really go anywhere and don't bring nearly as much drama to Gil's words as the original instrumentals did, as there are so many tracks here that just breeze by in a very fleeting way. Now, in a way, the sequencing of this project isn't too much unlike like other McRaven albums that have come out recently, like In the Moment or Highly Rare. However, I'm not sure if it's doing this LP any favors. And just to go further in detail with some of the instrumentals here, I do really miss some of the original backdrops and beats. Like, sure, the song Running might be a lot groovier and hip-hop inspired in this new reiteration, but damn if it doesn't suck out the intense sense of dread from the original track. But while the songs here that do come off milder are slightly disappointing, yes, nothing is more disappointing than the very messy and directionless and less than engaging flow of the record. It's as if the creative process behind doing this was to take the record, smash it onto the ground, and just try to Elmer's glue together the pieces and see what happens. I mean, don't get me wrong, originally the record was already very oddly shaped and one of a kind, strange, certainly an acquired taste, and I am impressed that this came together as coherently as it did. But now that I've listened to it, my curiosity has been quenched, and while there are elements of it that I like, I just don't feel a drive to come back to it, honestly. There were only a handful of tracks I found to be stand out, and the attempt to break the entire thing down into smaller fragments just lessened the project's impact and focus. Feeling a strong 5 to a light 6 on this one. Transition, have you given this album a listen? Did you love it? Did you hate it? What would you rate it? You're the best, you're the best. What should I review next? Hit the like if you like. Please subscribe and please don't cry. Hit the bell as well. Over here next to my head is another video that you can check out. Hit that up or the link to subscribe to the channel. Anthony Fantano, Micaiah McRaven, Gil Scott-Heron, forever.